Ceres is the closest dwarf planet to the Sun and the closest to Earth. It's a fascinating place that contains traces of the formation of the solar system and could have an ocean inside. However, most of what we know about Ceres was discovered less than 10 years ago. But in all of history, only one space mission has been able to study this celestial body. So if Ceres is such an interesting object, it could even have water, why have we only sent one space mission to study it? Is it tough to go to Ceres with modern technology? Join us to find out. Dawn Mission. The only space mission that has had the opportunity to study the dwarf planet Ceres thoroughly is NASA's Dawn Mission. The Dawn Mission was a milestone in space exploration, focusing on the detailed study of Ceres. Launched on September 27, 2007, this ambitious initiative was important for advancing our understanding of celestial objects in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. Dawn's space exploration probe was powered by an ion propulsion system, a revolutionary technology that enabled unprecedented efficiency in deep space. This technology is based on the ionization of xenon gas, creating a jet of electrically charged particles that, while providing modest acceleration, can be maintained for long periods. The ion propulsion system significantly changed how we approached long-duration space travel, allowing for greater autonomy and maneuverability. After its launch, the Dawn probe performed a series of gravitational maneuvers around Mars to adjust its trajectory and gain speed. On March 5, 2015, the Dawn spacecraft reached its final destination, the dwarf planet Ceres. This achievement marked the first close encounter with the dwarf planet and provided a unique opportunity to study this icy world in detail. Think carefully about this date. The first time in the history of humanity that a space exploration mission managed to fly over Ceres was on March 5, 2015, less than 10 years ago, according to the recording date of this video. Most of what we have discovered about Ceres is less than a decade old. One of the most notable features of Ceres that Dawn revealed was its mysterious bright spot in Akator Crater. This site, composed mainly of salt deposits, baffled scientists and sparked intense interest in the astronomical community. However, thanks to the Dawn mission, some hypotheses suggest that Ceres could have an internal ocean, which we will discuss further. The Dawn mission, originally planned to last 8 months, exceeded all expectations and provided crucial data for over 11 years. The spacecraft orbited Ceres in three distinct phases, and each provided a unique and valuable perspective on the dwarf planet. These phases, called high-altitude mapping orbit, low-altitude mapping orbit, and extended observing orbit, allowed scientists to collect detailed data on the topography, composition, and geological history of Ceres. The extraordinary duration of the mission was primarily due to the effectiveness of the ion propulsion system, which allowed Dawn to make precise trajectory adjustments and maintain an operational orbit even when other types of thrusters would have exhausted their fuel. This unexpected longevity provided a unique window to observe seasonal change on Ceres, particularly in the polar areas where bright areas suggesting the presence of water or ice were detected. The Dawn mission ended on November 1, 2018, when the probe ran out of xenon for its ion propulsion system. Despite this scheduled end, the rich amount of data collected continues to be the subject of intense research and analysis in the scientific community. NASA's Dawn mission expanded our understanding of Ceres and left a lasting legacy in space exploration. The ion propulsion technology used by Dawn has laid the foundation for future missions, providing an efficient and sustainable alternative for deep space exploration. However, could this technology facilitate future trips to Ceres? Perhaps a better question is, considering how difficult, expensive, and far away implying that going to this world is it worth sending a mission to Ceres again? Usually, after a space exploration mission finds nothing new or relevant, it is decided not to send a mission to that place again because space exploration probes are costly. So that we maximize resources, sending spacecraft only to places with a high probability of finding new findings and important discoveries. Fortunately, Ceres could have something of utmost importance to the scientific community and the world. Water on Ceres? One of Ceres' most giant puzzles, which scientists wanted to solve by sending the Dawn mission, involves a substantial bright white area several thousand miles wide that could be deposits composed primarily of sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate is a compound of sodium, carbon, and oxygen that usually comes from liquid substances such as water, also known as brine. When astronomers observed this enormous area for the first time, they deduced that it must be the result of some brine-like liquid that had evaporated on the surface of Ceres. But what they had not yet determined was where that liquid came from. By analyzing the data collected by the Dawn mission, scientists concluded that the liquid came from nothing more and nothing less than a deep deposit of brine or water enriched with salt. Is there water beneath the surface of Ceres? Everything seems to indicate yes, since by studying the gravity of Ceres, scientists learned more about the internal structure of the dwarf planet and were able to determine that the brine reservoir is approximately 40 kilometers or 25 miles deep and hundreds of miles wide. Other evidence that could point to this fact is that when micrometeorites hit an icy body like Ceres, the surface should be devastated with debris that darkens it over time, similar to what happens on the hidden side of the moon. But a bright area free of impact craters indicates that Ceres probably must have some kind of geological activity constantly renewing its surface. Research from the Dawn mission confirmed that the bright regions are young, some are less than 2 million years old. It also discovered that geological activity driving these deposits could be ongoing. On the surface of Ceres, salts containing water dehydrate quickly over hundreds of years, but Dawn's measurements show they still have water, so the fluids must have reached the surface recently. This is evidence of both the presence of liquid beneath the Akator crater region and the continuous transfer of material from the interior of Ceres to the surface. According to scientists, this could indicate Ceres is a water-rich world like other icy bodies that orbit gas giant planets, such as Europa or Enceladus, with the big difference that Ceres is much closer. Could Ceres be a world with an ocean of water beneath its surface? Let us know what you think in the comments. Another important aspect is that icy geological activity in our solar system occurs mainly on icy moons of gas giants, driven by energy produced due to gravitational interactions with their planets. But that's not the case with the movement of brines towards the surface of Ceres. On the contrary, it appears Ceres has geological activity, suggesting that other large ice-rich bodies that are not moons could also be active. As we see, Ceres is an exciting place where there could even be water. So in terms of scientific interest, it makes a lot of sense to send a space mission again to explore this world. But is there any mission planned to return to Ceres? The answer is yes. Next mission to Ceres. The coming decades will be dominated by sample return missions from various bodies in the solar system. In the last year, we have seen the Hayabusa 2 probe return with pieces of the asteroid Raigu and the Chang'e 5 with the youngest samples of the moon. Recently, we saw the OSIRIS-REx probe return with pieces of the asteroid Bennu. Later, NASA, ESA, and China will want to bring separate samples from Mars. However, first, China plans to collect samples from the asteroid 469219 Kamo-Awa with the Chang'e mission, while Japan plans to do the same with Phobos, the largest moon on Mars, thanks to the MMX mission. However, many other bodies in the solar system are candidates for a sample return mission, which could be next. In addition to the objectives above, the scientific community demands samples of comets, what is demonstrated by the failed proposal of NASA's CSER mission, developing the technology to bring back a piece of a comet while keeping the samples at cryogenic temperatures to avoid loss of volatiles is not easy at all. The most exciting targets after comets remain asteroids. And of course, since we're talking about the asteroid belt, why not bring a sample of Ceres? The Dawn probe discovered that Ceres is a fascinating small world that most likely had an interior ocean in the past. An ocean that perhaps could still exist, although in the form of a brine ocean. This makes Ceres the closest ocean world candidate, since it is much closer than Europa, Titan, or Enceladus. Remember that ocean world refers to celestial bodies with internal oceans under an outer crust of ice. The proximity to Ceres would greatly facilitate a possible sample return mission. In addition, Ceres presents hydrothermal and cryovolcanic activity that generates mountains like Ahuna Mons or the famous white spots of the Akator crater, formed by salt deposits such as sodium carbonate, apart from having a curious crust composed of a mixture of ice and rock. When a sample return mission like this is considered, the question is it essential or possible to send a robotic probe that studies this body better than NASA's Dawn mission did? In the case of Ceres, a sample return mission would allow a much better understanding of the composition of its surface and the deposits of salts and organic substances, allowing us to understand how this body was formed and what implications for astrobiology has. In addition, we would answer fundamental questions such as, did Ceres form farther from the Sun as the Dawn data indicates? Is this body a source of some carbonaceous meteorites that have fallen to Earth? Could life have arisen inside Ceres eons ago? To answer these and other questions, the Gauss mission has been proposed, which is the acronym of Genesis of Asteroids and Evolution of the Solar System, a space mission concept born in July of 2019 due to a Congress on Planetary Exploration held in Zhuhai, China. The mission is named after the famous mathematician Carl Friedrich Gauss. And what does Gauss have to do with Ceres? Well, at just 24 years old, this mathematical genius could calculate the orbit of the dwarf planet from three observations, which made it possible to find it again after having briefly lost track of it after its discovery on New Year's Day in 1801. The Gauss mission would obtain samples at a certain depth and from the outer regolith, which is a mystery since we do not know what precise organic substances give Ceres that dark color. The Gauss mission is still on the proposal table, but is not yet sure it will be carried out. Would you like us to make a video explaining more details about the Gauss mission? For now, we can say that going to Ceres is tough. Still, it is such an exciting place for scientific research and our knowledge about the solar system that it is 100% worth sending a mission again to explore this distant frozen world in the asteroid belt. Now it's your turn. Do you think the Gauss mission will be the next to visit the dwarf planet Ceres? Let us know your opinion in the comments.